Let us now get a clearer definition of how the splintering of the art whole manifests in the creation of different artistic forms and modes of expression. We will consider four main categories. 1. Traditional form. 2. Artist as his or her own creation. 3. Environmental earth art. And 4. Techno-media generated art. Through these examples, we can see how the multiple evolving art whole splinters to become the colorful compost of the forthcoming cosmoplanetary art whole. 1. Innovation of traditional form. This category includes many movements of modernism, i.e. cubist art, surrealist painting or abstract expressionism, hard-edged painting or realism. Each of these art forms revolve around the conventional idea, a painting on canvas in a gallery. Cubism is the classic example of deformation or reconstructing of form. When you view a cubist painting, your normal perception is dissolved and what you think you are supposed to be looking at appears fractured. Both cubism and futurism attempt to illustrate the body in movement on a two-dimensional plane in a frozen painting. There are different types of abstraction, such as the quasi-geometrical art of Mondrian that includes a flat pattern surface, or the abstract expressions of artists such as Jackson Pollock or William de Kooning, where paint is flung on the canvas in a spontaneous gesture. But even here, the painting is presented in traditional form on a canvas hung in a gallery. This innovative form process can also be witnessed in the theater. An example of this is playwright Samuel Beckett, who used the structure of traditional theater to create offbeat plays or dramas focusing on absurd qualities. This culminated in the creation of new theatrical forms, such as the theater of the absurd, etc., where grammar, semantics, fiction, and poetry were played within the vein of James Joyce's Ulysses and Finnegan's Wake. These are few examples of the splinters created from the innovation of traditional form. While this type of art is innovative, it still remains within the confines of traditional venues, such as art galleries. 2. Artist as his or her own self-creation. Beginning in the early 20th centuries and peaking in the 1960s and 70s, came a slew of non-traditional art forms that broke through form and context. These types of art can be viewed under the category of artist as his or her own self-creation, or the artist as a work of art, further elucidated in Chapter 4. This category includes body art, tattooing, piercing, performance art, types of dance, fashion and modeling, which is basically done through the photographic medium of style magazines, street theater, acrobatics, circus, mimes who stand all day on one street corner. An example of circus art is Le Cirque du Soleil, where skilled performance artists actually invoke and create alternative realities. This category also includes interventionist art and street art, which is often politically motivated with the intention of making a public statement. For example, street artists have done things like burn money at Grand Central Station or throw paint on the front door of the New York Stock Exchange. Happenings as performance or conceptual art are another form of this type of living dynamic manifestation that uses the body as a form of expression. To some degree, happenings still operate in a gallery, but at the same time, they destructure the myth of the gallery by transforming it into a space where strange, out-of-context events and occurrences, happenings, transpire that jar the mind out of conventional thinking. From the happening arose other forms, such as video events, where different videos are played simultaneously on several monitor screens. The videos might show, for example, nothing more than a refrigerator door in a house and how many times a day it is opened or closed. Andy Warhol created and was notorious for this type of video art displayed in movies such as Empire, where an unmoving camera filled the Empire State Building for a day in the same position. Warhol also made a film called Sleep, a 6-hour epic in which an unmoving camera films a man sleep. In 1966, Warhol made the film Chelsea Girls, where he set a camera in the Chelsea Hotel in New York for a long period and filmed the girls who lived there. These types of art forms represent the need of individual consciousness to break out of traditional forms. These types of art form often seem absurd, but are effective in breaking through the crust of tradition and culture built up over the millennia. In this process, the artist merely serves as an instrument to perforate this crust. Of course, this is merely an evolving stage. At the time these art forms were first expressed, there were less than 2 billion humans on the planet, compared with 6 billion in 2000. This tripling of population over one century would have a great impact on artistic art forms and styles of expression, augmented by the development of different media. Yeah.